It's party time as Dale Winton hosts the National Lottery's fourth birthday celebrations. The legendary Bette Midler provides the music, along with Ladysmith Black Mambazo. Culture Secretary Chris Smith will be there to explain how the lottery's developing. Simon London drops into a party for some lucky millionaire winners. And this week's draw is a super draw with a minimum guaranteed jackpot of £25 million. The National Lottery Draw, fourth birthday party, Saturday, 7:40, BBC One.
When the army think they've found an unexploded bomb, the four-legged evacuees are sent to the animal hospital. That's in half an hour here on BBC One.
Thanks for helping out last night. It was good of the cafe to let you off.
I'll call them later, tell them I can't come in tonight.
Well, you can't do that, you get yourself the sack.
Well, how else are you going to cope?
Well, Nonna said you'd help out during the busy period, and Janny's had the night to cool off.
Mum, he wasn't joking, he meant it.
You can't be serious about leaving the restaurant. It's a family business.
I did.
That's different. Can he be serious about working for Annie Palmer? You'll see, he'll come down those stairs in a minute, he'll apologise, and that will be that.
What's that for?
Well, if I can't be romantic on my anniversary, when can I be? Happy anniversary.
Oh, happy anniversary, open it.
I will later.
Well, go on, open it, and I can open mine too. You have got me one, haven't you?
Yeah, of course I have. It's just that, well, you know, I want to do it properly. Why don't we wait till we come back tonight after I've taken you to the most specialist restaurant you've ever been to?
Really?
Wherever you want to go.
2 years. Did you ever think we'd last that long? Be honest.
No. But I'm glad that we did.
I wouldn't mind, Oh, Dorothy, are you coming to join us?
I'm just doing a little tidy up, and I was looking for the vacuum.
Oh, I'm sorry, it's in my room.
Yes, I found it, and I noticed that your suitcase...
My suitcase?
Yes, I thought maybe you needed some help to unpack your things.
Have you been touching my belongings?
Oh, no, I wouldn't dream of it.
I've lived out of suitcases all my life, and I don't need anyone to tell me when to unpack.
There's gratitude for you. I was only trying to help.
What was all that about? Looks like a falling out between Inge and Brackett.
Why did you have to get so worked up and spoil it all?
Oh, Alex, what do you expect me to do? Turn the other cheek? You heard how your sister talked to me.
You could have spared a thought for her. Imagine what it must have felt like, being told your family's falling apart.
Oh, and you reckon family means that much to her?
Where are you going? He's inside having breakfast.
I can't stop right now, Mum.
But you promised me.
Something's come up at work.
So what am I going to do? Someone's got to get through to him.
Well, why don't you talk to him?
It's not coming from me.
All right, we'll have to wait till I get back now. Hopefully he's still around.
Do you want to know?
To be honest, I'm a bit phased. You sound perfect.
Great. When do I start?
You're always that confident.
Yeah. You're not going to hold that against me, are you?
Tonight suit you?
Suits me fine.
What are you studying, by the way?
Engineering. Electrical.
Work out, do you?
When I can.
This could be your lucky day, Ryan. Always in need of casual bar staff. Especially good lookers like yourself.
Who do you think's up there? The Wicked Witch in the North?
I already saw her the other day.
Yeah, well, not properly. I just go up there and say hello. Make me mum happy. I mean, how difficult is that? Oi! Do you think you're going?
I'm not feeling too good.
Come here. Keep me out of trouble, yeah?
Thanks.
Well, you got your work cut out there.
No, he's all right.
Phil, if it was company you're after, it'd have been cheap with a bar cock or spend.
You open, yeah?
Yeah, just about. Simon.
Yeah.
I've been wanting to have a word about your rent.
Yeah, I was late last month. Sorry, Phil. Won't happen again.
No, it ain't that. I'm afraid I'm going to have to put it up.
What?
I've got overheads to cover.
Well, how much?
As it's you, 10%.
I can't afford that.
Time to cut down on the drinking then, isn't it?
Hello, Rosa. I've been meaning to pop in.
Have you now?
Do you still want me to run those ads in the newspaper? Something the matter?
Don't you play your silly games with me, young lady. Have you any idea how difficult it is trying to run a restaurant single-handed?
No, but I can imagine.
Oh, and you're very sympathetic, I suppose.
If it's so difficult, why don't you get Gianni to pull his finger out?
You know very well you've poached him. How dare you offer my son a job? You know how this family depends on him.
He's a grown man. Surely he can do what he wants.
I want you to release him. Now.
He's not in chains, Rosa. Shame we can't say the same about you.
What's that supposed to mean?
Isn't it time you stop playing the martyr to your family?
What are you doing here?
Lunch. Oh, we had a free period.
Where were you the other day? Nicky said you're off sick?
Oh, we had a school trip, geography.
Why wasn't she on it?
She don't take geography.
Listen, if you're skiving off, it's not the worst crime in the world.
I'll just get off my back.
Ellie, didn't you hear me calling, yeah?
No.
I've got something to tell you.
Oh, sounds important.
Yeah, it is. I quit the restaurant.
Congratulations. What are your plans? Well, you know how bad the job market is at the moment.
I thought I had a job with you.
When did I say that?
You said that the other day.
Oh, you didn't think I was serious, did you?
Well, why on earth are you going to joke about something like that?
Sorry, Gianni, we must have got our wires crossed. The only job I've got going is a barman.
Well, if that's all you got, I'll have to take it until someone else leaves.
Don't hold your breath. I hired someone this morning.
Annie, your tea's ready.
All right. Just been to see Bea, but I think she's still asleep. I found this article on birthing pools for her. Ricky?
I suppose you think her having the baby at home's a good idea.
Well, yeah, it's great, isn't it? Well, Bianca said everything was all right.
Well, she got? She won't even get a proper checkup from the hospital. Now, I've gone along with everything so far. I've even backed her when she's refused the scans. But it's like my opinion don't count. Yeah, it's my baby too.
I'm sorry, Ricky. I didn't know you felt like this.
You ain't Courtney in the hospital. Can't you talk to her?
Well, I don't think she'd appreciate me getting involved.
But she listens to you.
All right, I'll have a chat with her. See what I can find out, yeah?
Thanks. Is that more posters?
No, it's not. And before you make any wisecracks, I'm doing massage, not rub downs.
Look, I'm sorry about Baronet not taking a mick the other day.
Yeah, well, I saw you laughing and all.
You know I didn't mean anything by it. You got anything planned for tonight? Anything nice?
Yep, Grant's taking me to a fancy restaurant and we're going to get plastered on champagne.
Not too much, I hope.
Ah, but we're going to make a night out of it.
It's nice to see you two doing okay.
Yeah, for a change, you mean? Everything's fine, Phil. Got no complaints.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. I knew it was only a matter of time before he came round. Me and Selva didn't suit him.
What? What's he been saying, Char?
Nothing. Look, I better go. I've got some calls to make.
Yeah, five and five ones, all right?
Cheers, yeah.
No problem.
Hello again. My mum's asked me to apologise. She'll be back to work as soon as she can.
Tell her not to be so silly. To concentrate on getting better. Do you want to join me?
Oh, well, I only popped in for some change.
Please, just for a minute.
Can I help you, madam?
Oh, what a charming young man. Two cups of tea, please.
Coming right up.
I hear you used to work at Camden.
That's right.
There's your Melanie. Don't you want to talk to her?
I'll go over in a minute.
So, why'd you leave then?
Oh, it was time to move on. I was getting stuck in a rut.
Oh, not a bad rut to get stuck in. The amount of money you must have been making there.
Money's not everything.
What now?
Schemes and other projects so that we can start to turn the tide. The data.